There we are. Hi, how are you doing today? Okay, so I want to talk to you about something that comes up a lot. And that is the question, how do I deal with difficult clients? How do I manage their expectations? Well, I'm going to tell you this. You are 100% responsible for the results that you're getting. And right now, you think you're going to be losing money, you think you're going to be losing clients by not giving all of your time to the clients who may be the most difficult clients that you have. But the thing is, this belief is actually going to hurt you in the long run. Now, I want you to know this is normal. This kind of thinking is normal. Maybe you can hear my dog in the background. He just sneezed. This is totally normal. This is something that every single practitioner has ever experienced. Whether you are a lawyer or not, you have clients who are taking your time. But the problem isn't your client. The problem is how you're thinking about your client. My name's Dina Cataldo. I am a life coach and a lawyer. And what I deal with most are stressed out, overwhelmed lawyers, people who need to get their lives back. And when they do, they're going to make more money, they're going to create a life that they love, and they're going to be able to manage things like client issues when they come up. And I'm going to share with you a few tips that you can implement today in order to rein your clients in. So this is such a valuable skill to have because once you master your mind, once you begin to recognize how you can make things easier in your life, you'll become more focused. You will become a happier person. And who doesn't want to work with a happier person? Come on. You're going to get more done. You're going to show up in the world in a different way. And that's going to attract more clients. And the clients who are already working with you, they are going to want to continue to work with you. So once you start recognizing it's not the fact that your clients are being unreasonable, the fact of the matter is you are 100% responsible for the results that you're getting, and you need to make the changes in order to rein your clients' expectations in. So, I want you to recognize some of the thoughts that come up with this. A lot of times, it doesn't have to do with the money or the fact that you're going to lose clients or money. It has to do with tying our self-worth in with our work. Because we have worked so hard to be where we are right now, we don't even recognize that we are working ourselves to the bone in order to prove to ourselves, to our friends, to our boss, that we are valuable. I want you to know right now that you are 100% responsible, but you're also 100% responsible for how you value yourself. When you don't recognize that, you let things slip like your boundaries with your clients. So it's important for you to recognize that you are valuable right now as you are 100%. You know, I know a lot of people say you are 100% lovable just as you are. Well, you are 100% valuable just as you are. You don't have to do anything different to be a smart lawyer, a smart business person. You are somebody who is obviously smart, or you would not be where you are right now. So I just want you to recognize your work, the time you put in at the office, has nothing to do with you as a human being. They are completely separate things. So let's talk about those three things you can do today in order to get your practice, get yourself reined in. All right, because these are the boundaries that you have to create in order to have a successful practice. Number one, I want you to look at what your voicemail says right now. If it just says something like, "Here's my name, this is what I do," and leave a message, that's obviously not enough. The reason it's not enough is because people expect in this day and age to have immediate responses. So there's two things I want you to think about when it comes to your voicemail. All right, because I understand that if you are an estate planner or if you are doing something where most people respond to the very first person who gets that call back, you want to make sure you're on top of that, but it doesn't have to be you. If you're a solo practitioner, there are tools out there. You can just Google them. You can Google anything from, there's one place that's called Ruby. There's other people who can answer those calls for you, and they can immediately reach you if necessary. Okay. So that way you are not monitoring your voicemail at all times. You're also not tied to something like your voicemail where you have constantly have to check it. You know you're getting a message in from somebody like Ruby or some other people that you actually have doing this work for you. So that way you know you need to respond to it right away. What I do with my voicemail, because I'm not a solo practitioner, what I work with mainly are witnesses and victims and attorneys who are calling me, and I'm in court so often that I'm not going to be able to return their call, and I need to make sure I'm setting up their expectations. So what I do is I say my name, I say the practice area where I'm in, the unit that I'm in. I give them my email address because I say my email address is the best way to reach me. That's what my preferred method of communication is. You've got to train people how to communicate with you. And then I also tell them I'm in court Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, so I will do the best that I can to return your calls on Tuesdays and Thursday mornings. And you can specify morning. So if they're calling in the afternoon, they're not expecting a call all day. So that is the first thing that you can implement today. It has cut down on so many people who are unhappy because they expected a call. Now I'm managing their expectations. Now I'm telling them this is when I'm reachable. This is my preferred method of communication. And this is why I can't reach you right now. It's not that their call isn't important to me. I'm very kind to them on that voicemail, but it's that I simply do not have the bandwidth to answer every single call, and especially can't do it while I'm in court. The second thing I want you to recognize is how many times you have people coming in and out of your office when you're trying to meet a deadline. If you notice that you are constantly irritated by people coming in and out of your office, it's time to do something different. You can create a quick sign. You do it once and you're done. If you want this, you can go ahead and comment below in this post with your email address or something that you want me to contact you. I'm actually going to create a freebie around this to make sure that everybody has a copy and you know exactly what to write, and it looks really pretty. So if you're feminine and like the feminine look, I got something for you. So I have a few different signs. I've got one where I can only work on intake right now because that's a certain project that I do. It's time sensitive. I have to have that notice up or people will come in and out of the office, in and out of my office, and I will not be able to get my work done. I need to be able to focus. I also need to make sure other people know that they can come in if they're dealing with intake. Another thing that I have on there is a lunch sign, because sometimes I come back from court, I need to have a few moments to myself, and people just feel free to come into the office if you don't have a sign up that says, please come back after lunch. So just recognize that you have control over who comes in and out of your office and when you are annoyed. If you notice that you're annoyed, then try one of those signs. I'm telling you, it works. Number three, your email. I can't tell you how many people I talk to who are afraid to put up an email notice saying they are out of the office. In fact, I think that's one of the most important things we can do to manage people's expectations. Because when we do that, we're making them happier. They understand, okay, I don't need to expect any response from this for the next 4 days. It's amazing how many people feel like they cannot put an out notice on their inbox. Now, the thing to remember is not to respond to your emails while you're out of the office. If there's a fire, obviously yes, but most things are not fires. Most things can be handled when you come back. The reason it's so important not to respond to those emails while you're out of the office is because you are setting expectations for your clients and other people who are contacting you that you are unavailable. If you are now responding to everything, even when you have an out sign on your inbox, then you are telling them, you know what, I have absolutely no boundaries. Go ahead and email me. I'll get back to you. So do not respond to them while you are out of the office. The next thing I want to make sure that you understand is that you don't respond right away to people's emails, because if they know it, you are at your desk responding back and forth, they're going to expect emails immediately thereafter. So if you walk away from your desk, you might get an angry email back saying, hey, where are you? No, You set the time to read your emails and respond to your emails. Now, you may be in the situation in which you have some important emails coming up. Just leave your inbox open. Do not have your email notifications on. Do not respond to emails that are not urgent until after you've finished your project. When you do this, you're actually creating a focused environment for yourself. You're actually going to work more efficiently. Your product is going to be so much better. You are going to feel so much better, and more people are going to want to work with you because you are happier. So I want you to implement these things. And if you are searching for more ways to feel less stress, to reduce the overwhelm in your life, I want you to subscribe to Soul Roadmap Podcast. I actually talk to a lot of practitioners. I also tell you ways you can do different things in your practice so that way you can make your life easier. I suggest starting with episode number 51, which is 9 secrets to doing more in the office with less stress. I find that that's a popular episode, and that is something that we could all use a little bit of help with. All right, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.